is Uncle Mark in the mothership. Three string cigar box guitar. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I am playing here through my Mesa. It's what I sound like. Very on the trebly side, as opposed to the bassy side, the trebly side. Song is for Halloween, Werewolves of London. Just a killer Halloween song, and I play it for the first time. I played it live last week. It was a great, went over really well. Everybody knows it. It's a good song at the bar for any time, but it's especially good right now for Halloween. So if you need yourself a Halloween song, this is your best bet. It's one of the easier songs. I don't want to hear any of the similarities. You'll say, oh yeah, it sounds like Sweet Home Alabama. No, it doesn't. Okay? And so let me play a little bit of this for you and show you why that's true. And I've got my little clear slide. I made this out of a bottle so that you can see through it. All right? So, here we go. Werewolves of London. Werewolf with a Chinese menu in his hand, walking through the streets of Soho in the rain. Hook for a place called Lethal Hook. Gonna get a big dish of beef chow mein. Ah, ooh, werewolves of London. Ah, ooh. Ah, ooh, werewolves of London. Ah, hear him howling around your kitchen door. You know you better not let him in. Little old lady got mutilated late last night. Werewolves of London again. Ah, ooh, werewolves of London. Ah, ooh. Ah, ooh. Werewolves of London. Ah-hoo. All right, all right, all right, all right. I'm going to take this off for right now. We don't need it. And of course, you know, if you put it on this finger, you have to use your pinky, so... Just throwing that out there for you all that use it on different fingers. So here's the deal with this song. It's a typical G, C, D song. Yeah, it's kind of like Sweet Home Alabama, but it's not. So let's go through what we got here. So we have G is open, G, D, G. G, G sharp, A, B flat, B, C. This is the chord that's important. And then see your dots. C sharp D, it's the chord that's important. D sharp E, F, F sharp G, chord that's important. Okay? So you're on your D chord. You're going to start on D, but you have to start on D with this note attached. Okay? That's a B. So you got to go. So you gotta start with this note on, as opposed to the, you're gonna start with this note. So you gotta come up from the bottom, and then rock and roll rhythm, then start. That's the difference. Come up, you're on that. So your fingers here on the D all the way across. You start with your third finger or your pinky, whichever you really want to do, okay, on that B. So I'm just down, down. Down, down on the C with your finger there on the A. And then we're back to the old rock and roll rhythm here in G, and you're going to use your second finger here, okay, on that E. So there's a, so it's a hammer on, okay? So I pluck the D and land on the E and then hit that G. And that's kind of very much what Sweet Home Alabama does. It does a, so that's a little trick of this song. So you're down and down. Down on the D string, down on the G string, but with this little hammer on. Okay? So kind of get used to that little movement. If you're watching baseball, you're watching the World Series, or you're watching your kids play, you can practice this with the volume off, you know, and you can practice it like this. Same thing. So down, off, off, off. You're gonna find this the most challenging part is to come up with this on. That's gonna be your biggest challenge, is to come up from here. It was my biggest challenge. That's why I'm saying that. I believe it was the hardest part of me learning this song. Alright. You slide. You can put it on any finger you want. You can put it on here. You can put it on here. It doesn't matter where you put it. Put it on three. You can still do it. Like so. Okay. So that's how you would do it. The slide part, and this is the way I do it. I know it's not perfect, and I know it's not exactly what you expect, but you know, you're playing at the bar, and you know what? All those people drinking and playing with their phones, they do not care. They want to hear familiar lyrics that they can sing along to. And they want to hear a little bit of how the song meanders, okay? So, you're going to go to D. So I like to come up with a strum, and then I come back with that high G string. And then I come down on all of these strings. And head up to 12. And you can just fool around with this any way you want. And that's kind of what I do with it. I just kind of play with it. That's all my audience really cares about, and I would bet that your audience is about the same way. Most people, like I said, want familiar lyrics. They want to be able to go, ow, Werewolves of London. After that, they don't really care. So the slide part breaks up the, Werewolves of London. Ah, ooh. good for 5, 6, maybe 7 choruses. You can get going on. Come on, everybody, let's do this. Yeah. Ow, come on. Ow. I'm telling you, it's going to go over huge. It's a big, big bar song. Everybody likes it. Slam, bam, bar song. I just wanted to give you that. It's Halloween. You got to get ready for Halloween. So if you're watching some football, or you're watching baseball, you're watching basketball just started, you know, you can sit here and practice this. Do whatever you want with this song. In that space, now you got a space to work with. Just work with that space. Decide what you want to play in there. Make this song your song. Not my song, your song. Find out what you'd like to do. Also, for you beginners, there's really, you can just play here. The hairy-handed gent that ran amok in Canada. Lately he's been overheard in Mayfair. They're just downs. Better stay away from him. He'll rip your lungs out, Jim. Ha! I'd like to meet his tailor. So if you're just a beginner and just want to play this down, down, down stroke, go right ahead. No one's gonna say anything. It's a good song. It's solid. Get the lyrics right. You don't have to sing it high or low. You can sing it any way you want. You can change it up. So great Halloween song. It's Uncle Mark in the Mothership. Thank you so much for everything you guys do for me. I really do appreciate it. I do have a link down below. It's a paypal.me/UncleMarkTips. It's a virtual tip jar. Also, and I'm using that for a big thing, so big news coming soon. Thanks for all of the things you do for me on social media. I really, really appreciate it. Everything you do for me is just awesome and amazing, and getting the word out and letting other people know and reminding folks that, you know, I have this channel here and that you can enjoy it anytime. And thank you so much. I'm coming on my 1-year anniversary, so I'm thinking of something big for that. Appreciate it. Everything you do. Thank you so much.